Capcom 1991.
Licensed by Nintendo.
Capcom presents.
Oh, third time.
Crowned at 200X.
Household robots rock and roll were created by master robot designer.
Dr. Light!
And we're enjoying their peaceful days. Then one day, the industrial robots all over the world went on a ravage, and the world fell into a total chaos.
With Mega Man 2 seizure explosions.
Dr. Light!
Quickly realized that mad scientist
Dr. Wily
was.
Yes?
Behind the nefarious deed, but he didn't know what to do. Rock having. A strong sense of justice volunteered to be converted into a. He looks like a doll. Fighting robot, just the super robot, Mega Man was born!
Hooray!
Flash Man!
And time for an epic shot, after he slowly awakens.
Wake up, bitch.
Blah, 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 blah.
Nice eyes.
Ah! White screen.
Black screen. Wind! Mega Man shattered
Dr. Wily's
plans 3 times, and...
Not counting Wily Wars.
World peace has been maintained so far, but history, of course, repeats itself.
Again.
Dr. Cossack!
A mysterious scientist had invented 8 powerful robots and sent them after Mega Man. Mega Man starts for the battle again.
Yay!
This time equipped with the powerful new Mega Buster!
In other words, he gets to charge his laser now.
And guess what is late?
The train!
Obviously, a reference to Jimmy Carter, right?
Yeah, alright, so we got 8 new Robot Masters led by
Yay!
Dr. Kolsek.
Mega Man 4!
We got Ring Man, Dive Man, Skull Man, Bright Man, Pharaoh Man, Toad Man, Drill Man, and Dust Man. Let's go after. Dive Man!
And guess what it was 2 days ago?
It was your birthday!
Yeah!
I don't know if that was with syncing with the music because I don't have my headphones on.
It was perfectly synced, by the way.
Wow. then I'm just a cyborg, I guess.
Can you drown?
No. But they're death spikes. And where's water, they're death spikes.
Hey look, gold spikes. That means instant kill, right?
Yeah, even the golden ones that are only underwater.
Yeah. Yeah, it's play old Mega Man. This is good, by the way.
Yeah, alright, so we have the dolphin that we have to... get rid of here.
I think
he's called Moby.
That's a whale.
A whale? Why did I think it was a dolphin?
A giga whale!
Graphical limitations for the win. Anyway, here we got a new character called Eddie. He will give you random power-ups from E-Tanks to... And he gives you health and weapon energy. Which is really useful, and I got
those
an E-Tank.
Those were stairs, by the way.
Yes. And I got an E-Tank from Eddie, so that's really nice. That's actually pretty rare.
Eddie? What?
I said Eddie.
Whoa.
I think Eddie is actually a Japanese name, but...
I've heard Heavy.
Yeah, well, you just wish to hear that.
Yeah, I wish.
Next, Moby!
Moby! Why isn't it white?
Alright, usually pits are bad, but in this case, you can just fall down. Because there's actually a nice reward you can get here.
Oh my god.
Going down.
Oh god, that's very close to spikes.
Because over here, we obtain the wire upgrade.
The wire upgrade? Oh, now you can attach wires to your bullets.
Now you can cling to the ceiling, do the ceiling clinging things.
Oh, look at that. All the way back over here.
But basically, if you get something like that, you go back to the checkpoint of the level, regardless of you actually reach the checkpoint or not. Even if you don't reach the checkpoint, you will actually go there, of which there is one case where it actually will happen.
Let's just say that you go to a certain checkpoint.
Yeah, well, at least it's not a checkpoint before the boss.
Hey, you can jump higher, Mark.
And this time I'm going to jump over it.
fucked up spy, but that there are spies on top makes no sense. Or does it?
I know in this particular screen transition you can jump really high, and if you do that you kill yourself because you can't stop yourself when you're in the screen transition. Yeah.
Oh, already?
Alright, so it's time for Dive Man. Dive Man is actually really easy if you know what to do.
Hey, I saw you charging your shot.
Yeah, you basically hold the button and you'll basically do triple the damage.
Arsman 2.0!
Okay, so he basically charges at you once, then he shoots
He's not that hard.
Three dive missiles at you, then he just charges at you again, and that's pretty much all there is to it.
Arsman 2.0, he's actually easy, man.
No, that's Proto Man. But as long as you are, like, far away from him, he will keep in this pattern. If you're too close to him, he will actually charge into you three times instead of once. So, yeah.
Victory. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba.
My turn.
No, my headphones. I mean, your headphones that were in my head. Oh god, here we go again. No. You got dive missile.
Yay.
And the color barely changed, but oh well.
Oh, what was that? What was that grab, by the way?
That was the password thing. Anyway, now we go to Drill Man.
Master of all things.
Drill.
Drill?
What? It is Drill Man. Yay.
Yay, let's see if you can drill through the ground here. Well, it is kind of like a mining site?
Okay, I think those ladybugs are called helibugs or something. I know that this thing is called Big Jump or something.
Big Jumper.
Something like that. I don't know all the names by heart. Because that would just be too crazy. And these guys are not bubble bats, by the way. They are called Batontons, which are actually nerfed in this game. And here's a one-up that's actually really hard to get because on the way back I always kill myself. But I'll just take the hit just to safely get past the
spikes. These are instant kill spikes.
Obviously.
But of course. And here you can jump to high. Apparently. Alright.
Going up.
I wonder how many Mega Man I'm going to be.
Well, I'm planning to do Mega Man 5 and 6 solo.
And but I want to annoy you.
With what? Okay, anyway, here's the wire. You press up and you just fire like that,
oh,
and there you go.
Oh, that's useful.
Yeah, I don't think very many people use it.
Well, useful to getting to some places.
Also, it looks like I'm doing really well, but I actually barely practice in this game, so you might be in for some suckage.
Well,
just saying.
Well, actually... Or just have... no. The big brothers of these blocks. Well, actually, you can see by the flashing thing over on the right screen. See?
And as you see, those switches make ground appear. I guess if you're as crazy as Dr. Wily, you just have the power to just disobey physics like that.
Yeah. That was it already? Wow, the stages are going fast.
Okay, anyway, we're going to Drill Man. Drill Man is actually pretty tricky. When he does a particular...
He's going to drill you!
When he does a particular attack, basically. But, okay, at this first move, he will basically drill in the ground, and after a certain amount of seconds, he will just jump up again. The drill bomb is tricky, because you have to jump earlier than you think, because the explosion can also hit you.
Yeah.
Further, he can also jump really high, but that's just predictable, so don't worry about that. That's pretty much all there is to this thing.
Or he keeps diving like that, and the boss is easy.
Yeah, also when he drills underground, he's also invincible. And also the drill bombs will deflect your shots, so yeah, that's also not nice.
Well, wow, the charge shot is really powerful.
Now, also something that I think that's really evil in this game, all the robot masters, with the exception of one, if you touch them, they do 8 HP of damage, which is a third of your total health. The only robot master that doesn't do that is Pharaoh Man.
Because he's a Pharaoh or something.
Yeah, that's logical, apparently.
My turn!
Okay, fine.
And here we go again.
And now we get...
Let me guess.
You got... Drill Bomb.
Bombs?
Pshoo! Got it.
Ooh!
You got... Rush Jet... Adapter. Adaptor!
Tor! It's Swiss Dog!
And now
Dog
we go-
makes an H!
And now we go after... TOGMAN!
Oh my god.
Who is pretty much the easiest robot master in video game history.
Mega Man history. Are there any other games that are robot masters? Sure. Easiest game! Easiest robot master gets hit immediately.
I actually just found out an even easier pattern to beat that guy.
Flying Penguin!
As you can see, because it's raining and there's wind, there are actually wind physics in this stage. So.
Oh my god.
And, oh, one up. Yay. Which, if this was Ro Mithril's channel, that would be a bad sign.
Flying Penguins! And, oh my god, this is a... Yes,
and now we're in World 1-2, or something. Let's just assume this is... Yep. Ow. What?!
How did you get killed?
Apparently I didn't jump right. Well, here we go, guys. Suck It begins. Anyway, let's do this right, shall we?
You should have been called Sewer, man.
I don't know if I'm gonna cut that out or not, so... if I do, you're gonna miss some of the commentary. Yay, the jump didn't get me this time.
You should have been called Sewer Man.
Well, just because it's a sewer doesn't mean it has to be the rogue master needs to call like that. Anyway,
Sewer Man, master of all sewers.
Master of all 1-2s.
It's a snail dog.
And we got a snail. This thing can basically throw its eyes at you or just toss a bomb.
It's a...
You can only hit it when the eyes are open, that's pretty much about that. And this is actually the first one of the two, because we're gonna fight another one.
Plumber Man!
But this time with a waterfall!
Ooh. It's not that scary.
Yeah, you just throw your eyes.
Huh.
I think it's called Escaru or something.
I see what you did there!
What? Okay, this...
I see.
Here I just jump for a fish to spawn, and he's not spawning! Thank you. Dude!
Props to you, mate.
All that time... That whole time that I practiced wasn't a lot.
Two!
I actually jumped that wrong. Okay, we did it.
And then you die.
Ow. Alright, so
close enough.
Alright, it's time for Toadman. Toadman is
easy
as hell.
Wow, whole game is easy.
He has one attack that he will prepare by doing some wavy...
Lightman! Lightman!
By doing a wavy animation. If he pulls it off, he will do the rain flush, which is impossible to dodge. But if you just do this... Yeah, that's it.
Oh my god, really?
No, don't hit me!
And then Toad explodes into pieces.
Oh, and by the way, all of his
attacks... Finally, I got rid of that annoying thing!
All of his attacks do 8 HP of damage, by the way, so if you somehow get hit, it can be very...
Oh, difficult.
Well, not...
You got... a ring flush!
Which actually is a really useful weapon, because it fills the entire screen.
So it instantly kills everyone on screen?
You got Rush Marine Adapter!
Which is the most useless power-up ever, because the only practical way to use it in is in Dive Man stage, which I already
did. Bright Man!
And now we go to Bright Man!
He
is here to light up your life!
Really? A light bulb?
Wow. Also to be considered the cheapest Mega Man boss in the history of Mega Man. Okay, so we got light bulb enemies. If you kill them, they will turn off the light.
Fireworks.
And you have enemies that make fireworks appear, that basically lights up the room.
Everything is lights.
And then over here we got Totem Poland, which if you jump over it, it will jump.
It's a cricket.
And here we got a grasshopper that's called that grasshopper is called a Baten, by
that's
the way.
Super Mario World reference. Jumping up a grasshopper which kills itself. Yoshi.
If you can call that a grasshopper. Well, I guess in Majora's Mask they call Link Grasshopper, so, well, I guess it works.
Wow. Nice one, Capcom.
Okay, so, if you go down here, there's no reason why you should. Well, there's a reason, but it's completely optional. You don't have to go this way, but if you go here...
Whee!
You will get yourself an E-Tank and a 1-Up. Sadly, you have to use utility weapons to actually get back. So I'll just use the jet.
Rush jet!
Also, in this game, Rush jet will only go forward in this game. You don't have fully control over him. And this time, you also cannot spam the jump button to not deplete the ammo of it. So, yeah, in Mega Man 3, that thing was broken as hell. But they downgraded it, which was a good idea, yet at the same time not.
Grasshopper! Grass hopping, even though these are spikes.
Yeah, you're not exact. Well, maybe the spikes are grass.
Then... No, Yoshi! Don't kill yourself again!
It's actually a pretty hectic room, that actually.
Oh...
I get scared of it,
wow.
But I made it, whatever. So,
whatever.
Onward to the final room. Here we have some light bulb enemies too, and I do not recommend that you kill them. If you do kill them, well, the platforms will still be visible, but there's a certain platform that you won't see where you actually have to jump on. And if the lights aren't on, you won't be able to see it.
The green ones?
No, the red ones, these. Okay, what the hell just happened there?
You walked off. Really? Burp! I heard.
Alright, just cut away.
Go Mega Man! Go Mega Man!
Okay, we're back in this room. Let's try that again. I don't know what happened.
You didn't cut anything.
I don't know what happened there, but for some reason I just died there.
For some reason you were stupid.
Or the game was just being stupid.
Oh, I see. Pixel perfect jumps.
Okay, this thing you actually have to kill, because if you don't, you get hit and you will instantly go into the pit. And we find the gate in the dark.
Where's...
Alright, so Brightman, there is actually a secret strategy to this guy. Basically, he has one attack, which is called the Flash Stopper. If he uses that move, you're completely helpless. And I'm not even... And I'm serious about that. He will just freeze you, and he can just do whatever he wants. Now, there are three HP values where he will use this move. If you don't get him in this... And there he goes, and he's just gonna jump into me cheaply. I think when he takes 12 HP of damage, 20 HP of damage, and 24 HP of damage, he will use those, use the Flash Stopper. If you don't get him to those HP values, he won't use it.
Oh, that's why you use charge stacks.
And there are not very many people that actually know that. And even with if you use a Rain Flush, the HP values that I just mentioned, they will always go to those values, no matter what, as far as I can tell.
Alright, you got...
Flash Stopper!
Which is probably overpowered or something.
It is overpowered, but I don't use it in the stage at all.
Alright, Pharaoh Man! Pharaoh Man!
Now go after Pharaoh Man! Wow, he actually synced it right.
Yes.
As long as you get away from the wires.
But you got the wires.
No, I don't. I'm not.
Yes.
I'm not having them in my hand.
Yes, go to your menu.
Oh, just shut up.
You see, you have wires.
Alright, so we have strange enemies.
Wait, can you die in a quicksand?
Yeah, if you stay in it for long enough, if you like to. Don't know why you want to, but...
Just asking, does the quicksand kill you, or just because it goes to a bottomless pit?
Well, it's basically when you go off-screen, you just kill yourself. Anyway, if you go over here, I just jumped over that pit, which is actually nearly impossible to jump over normally. But if you get here, you get yourself the magic balloon.
No seriously, is this a magic balloon?
Well, no, it's just called the balloon, but I called the magic balloon, and I would go to a checkpoint where we actually never went to. That's an example.
You skipped.
I only skipped one room in particular, by the way. So, yeah, no big. The only thing that is there are, bug flyers,
You got boobs!
Oh wow, you got lucky there. They see me sliding, they're hating.
Alright, so now we...
Oh god, we got interrupted.
Do we?
Yes, we got interrupted.
No, we don't.
Yes, I hear people. Boss!
Alright, anyway, we have these footholder-like enemies, but these will always just go into the direction you need to go. And mummies! And Pharaoh Man it is!
Oh, wow. That was, again, really fast.
Alright, so...
Isn't the stages
Pharaoh Man has two attacks. He can use the Pharaoh Shot that has small bullets, which he does pretty wildly right here. And he can use a charged version of it. The charged version is obviously easier to avoid.
He looks hard.
He only jumps, or just the charged Pharaoh Shot when you're close to him. When you're far away from him, he will use the small shots most of the time.
Break that boss.
Ow.
Four.
And that's 4 damage, not 8. As I said, this guy is the only one that actually does less damage when you have contact with
him. Still a lot.
Well, 4 is still a lot, but 8 is just ridiculous. But, you know, what are you gonna do, right?
And all of your health is Kaizo.
What? Never mind. So, speaking of that, I still need to do Kaizo 2.
You got feral shots!
By the way, at the time that I'm actually recording this, I have actually never finished Kaizo 2, just saying.
Dustman! Dustman!
Now we go after... Ringman! It is the Lord of the Rings, it is Ringman!
Give me those headphones!
Which is also one of the most annoying stages ever. These particular rooms in particular.
Can you get crushed by that beam?
And you will probably also recognize that these platforms were also in Brutal Mario World. Well, they originated from this.
One up!
I'm getting it. Even if I don't know if I get affected by the one up curse, but we'll see that, I guess. Well, I guess I already did, kind of.
There's a one up curse.
Yeah, in World Mithril's channel there is. This one up cause death.
I want those headphones! What? Why not? It's a big platform!
Hippo! Hippo Man!
That's really hippo.
That burps out rockets.
What?
No. Alright, anyway, moving on.
Saw Blades! Totally not Super Mario World.
Yeah.
Super Slow-Mo World!
I want that! I don't care, I want it.
Wow.
And it's mine, my friend. Alright, here we got a ring-based mini-boss, which you can only hit if it dispenses its rings.
Welcome to the Ring of Fire!
Oops.
Rush Jet?
Oops.
Oh, wire.
And time for King Hippo the Second!
King Hippo the Second. Wow, that's cheap.
If you're really good, you can also get rid of the missiles. But it's really hard.
You need to get lower.
Lower? Yeah. If I could.
Stairs!
Alright, Eddie, what you got for me? E-Tang, thank you.
Exactly. That was the worst one I ever made.
The best ones are fun and good.
No. Well, something. Hey look, these are made out of bullets.
Whoa, skip frame.
Or something.
Yeah, and these go the other way, by the way. In case you didn't see. Also, what I like to say that if you slide on the on these platforms, it won't actually register as if you were typically standing on it. So that way you can actually make the platform disappear later than otherwise.
Game is bugged.
And here we have one more ring enemy.
In the ring of fire.
Oh wow. And there we go.
Yay.
And as you might remember, in Ringman also appeared in Brutal Mario World. Well, in Brutal Mario World, he pretty much has the same pattern as in this game.
Flash Man again! Yes, because you're flashing.
Or Mega Man is poisoned. Alright, so Ringman, when he uses his Ring Boomerang, you want to be sure that you run away from him as you jump over it. That's the easy way to avoid it. Also, don't shoot him twice on a cycle, because then it'll just shoot another one and that one will just hit you, which is not smart. Unless you know that that shot is going to kill him.
Oh wow, that shot went further. Well, how much does the ring damage?
The ring probably does like around 4 damage, I'm not exactly sure. But it doesn't matter because now we got the Ring Boomerang!
Oh, finally! And why did you want the headphones?
Because I control over it, just saying. We get...
You got... the Ring Boomerang! Yay!
With an ugly color, but oh well. Now we go after Dustman! Master of all things dust, it is Dustman!
Good sing. Hey, chainsaws!
Alright,
I see chainsaws, by the way. Oh no, wait, don't find chainsaws. Those are conveyor belts.
Alright, here we have up and down that will try to drag you into the pit.
And dude, the ground is made out of scrap.
And we got shield attackers, which actually appear in Mega Man 4 and onward. So they're pretty much going to be a staple in the game from here on out.
They also appeared in early Mega Man. I saw them.
Well, not shield attackers. That's for sure.
Why is he called Scrap Man? Because the whole made is scrap.
Maybe you're mistaking them with Sniper Joes or something.
No.
By the way, there are no Sniper Joes in this game. Sorry. There are Skeleton Joes, by the way. Just saying, they're a Skullman stage.
I can already guess where they're going to appear.
Gee, I wonder.
Can you get killed by the platforms by getting crushed?
Well, the platforms don't actually stand up forever. If you take too long, they will just fall.
Lol.
And Eddie, what do you got for us? Health? Thank
you. Hurt you.
Eddie? Oh. Yeah, Eddie can hurt me.
Eddie!
Alright, so this is what I consider to be called the glitch room. Because, you can do a lot of fun glitches here. As you can see, this mat is in the air. Fun.
Break those blocks like a bastard!
Blocks like a bastard!
Oh god, this one you have to go fast. Probably.
Alright, so here you just have to get rid of some of that garbage and then just go back and try it again.
Garbage.
Ooh!
Well, throwers make risks. Remember that, kids.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All that scrap. I can see some faces in it.
Well, I guess it's supposed to be the inside of a vacuum.
It's a vacuum cleaner!
Also, that man that I just killed actually spins around and actually takes 3 hits to kill.
Oh, wow, and here they get burned. Vacuum cleaners don't burn.
Well, in this world they do, and I guess it sort of makes sense. So they get rid of the garbage or immediately. Alright, so Dustman is...
That's a giant square cannon on his head.
Speaking of
Ow!
Dustman is not hard, but when it comes to his dust crusher, it all comes down to timing. Basically, when it reaches you, you have to jump straight, like this. Well, of course if you do it right, like that. And further you can use his vacuum that will suck you in, and he's invincible while he's doing that. And if he keeps doing that, that's also great.
Doesn't look all that strong, the vacuum.
Well, the vacuum attack is easy, but you can't attack him while he's doing it. That's the problem. And if he keeps doing that, that prolongs the video by more and more.
I missed!
I have stuff to cut out anyway, those deaths. I mean, now I have the power of editing anyway. Well, I did before, but I'm just more skilled in it.
Oh god, who's going to win? Who's going to win?
The winner is Mega Man!
No! I wanted you to die! No!
Okay.
No, now you had the headphones 5 times and I 3 times. You had 2 times in a row, man!
I tried to drink water and it drips onto the left side of my face!
Yeah. Dust Crusher!
Yay, we're Game Boy all over again.
AKA Old Mega Man, because he's now gray!
And onward to Skull Man!
Master of all things skeleton!
And death peoples.
On one live skeleton text. Oh wow! Really? Bones?
And his music is awesome, by the way. Do 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 do.
Oh wow, they respawn.
Yeah, everything in the NES Mega Man world respawns.
Hey, one up.
Hopefully no one up curse. Alright, these are skeleton Joes. If you want to kill them, you need to use a charged Mega Buster shot. Otherwise, you can just make them crumble and you can just walk past them for the few seconds that it's dead, sort of.
Oh, I want to make a pun out of this world.
What was your pun then? Hi, Eddie.
What do you think of pun?
E-Tank.
Does this music give you a nostalgia boner? Nah, that one was...
That bad pun, even though it only has the word bones in it.
nah, that wasn't good.
Alright, anyway, we've got an E-Tank over here, so I'll get
a
it.
Magic balloon!
Also, as you might notice, the balloon is actually more like a reskin of item 1 of Mega Man 2. Thank you.
Still get damaged.
Well, you know, at least I make up for the deaths, so I actually get more 1-ups. And I'm actually also pretty lucky with the E-Tanks that Eddie gives me. Because E-Tanks are actually extremely rare. And I just got 3 in out of 4.
Can you fall to death or do you just go to the stage down?
Well, that would be pretty obvious.
Hey look, it's worm enemies!
Worms. Alright, anyway, there's an E-Tank that you can get here. I only recommend getting this with the balloon, otherwise if you use Rust Jet, you're just asking for trouble.
It's a magic balloon! Can I get crushed?
Yeah, you can actually get crushed, and there's one particular stage where that happened to me several times.
Another one of- how many one-ups do you have?
I got 7 lives.
You can have 99?
No, 9.
Oh wow.
As well as 9 E-Tanks.
Wow, this game is short. Because these stages are so short.
So very short. Alright, here these skeleton Joes are going to be a real pain in the butt. Okay, we're back. We had a quick little interruption, but we're back. Alright, so anyway, we're going
Poison
to-
Poison Man again!
Poison Man!
What?
Okay,
No Lines Man!
Skull Man is actually pretty tough.
Poison Man versus Skull Man!
So let me explain,
See a dinosaur.
He will basically shoot at you wherever you are, then he jumps towards you and uses the skull barrier. After that, he walks towards you really fast, and you need to jump over him when that happens. It's actually pretty easy to get hit by this guy, I'm not gonna lie.
What?
Because his hitbox is actually pretty big. At least in my opinion, it is. Just as soon as the skull barrier disappears, just jump for it, because otherwise you're just gonna die.
Alright, old...
Skullman is dead!
Yay!
Well, he was kind of dead, but now he is... Shiny explosions!
Yeah. All robot masters defeated. At least,
so
far.
So Mega Man was kind of like Nemor for one stage. by the way, if you know what I'm talking about, you're awesome.
You got... Skull Barrier!
Which is a very spectacular weapon.
Almost no color change, but... Whatever.
And with that, we go to Dr. Cossack's Russian Fortress!
It's the Am I right? Skull. Oh, I love Russians.
I remember this from Brutal Mario World.
It's
why is there so much that there in this game?
Hey look,
there
it's
are
a
so much
it's
that
a
reminds me of Brutal Mario World. I don't know, I've got a face of Mr. Mega Man. I'm so happy with that.
Give me those headphones. I don't know this song. Apparently. Go down. Or not. Hey look, it's an ice fortress. What were you doing there?
I always get hit there on purpose.
You shut the wall. What were you doing?
I was doing it with the music.
Oh.
Because that's fun.
Oh wow, double kill.
Yeah, you can do a lot of double kills in this room.
Oh, charge shots go through multiple enemies.
That too. Up and down, are you working with me? Thank you.
Oh! Slide. Or, whoa, you need to find your death. Yeah. Rush Jets!
I'm actually surprised that I'm already at 9 lives, even though I got killed so many times.
Go, go, go!
Oops. Though I missed. Oh my god!
I really want to go out. Oh wow, snow.
I don't know if you know if you saw it, but in one of my Mother 3 videos, someone said, "Oh my pork," and I was like, "Oh my pork." That's funny.
I tried to follow it, but it stopped after a while. So.
Well, your last comment was at part 20, so you're. I'm actually surprised that you actually followed it as well as you did.
Well, I skipped a lot.
As far as I could tell, you skipped 2 videos, but whoop-de-doo.
It's probably more than that.
Alright, anyway, now we're going to the first
Poison Man!
Kolsekables. This thing, I believe, is called...
It's a behemoth.
I think
it's a moth.
Behemoth, I thought... For some reason, that made me think of... it's not Behe, Jim. It's not a Pokemon. This thing is called Mothfire, I think. So basically it will try to make holes in the floor and try to kill you that way, which is mean.
So after, if you don't fight the boss
man,
you will just die because he makes holes in the floor?
Well, he can only make 3 holes and they're always in the same position. They're
and
Mega
Man goes up! In some kind of
Dr. Cossack stage 2.
So why did they decide to add a Russian in this game? Explain to me. Give me those headphones.
You'll get them after the third stage.
Because
I say so. Another 1-up! A 1-up that I probably...
How much 1-ups do you have?
You know, even though I fail so much on screen, I actually also do get a lot of E-tanks and 1-ups as in on screen.
This game is easy.
Another 1-up! The game just wants me to die.
I don't get it.
The game just knows, like, oh, he knows Roe Mithril's 1-up curse. We need to get from a lot of them so you can die even more.
But I don't get it. One thing I don't get. Why add that 0 there when you can only have 9 1-ups?
Yeah, I don't know why there are 2 digits, but there just are. I think not all Mega Man games actually have that. Anyway,
these spikes kill you.
No, even though they're spikes, they won't kill you instantly, but they will hurt. Not that much, but. But if you get hurt, you also go down one screen, and I don't know why you want to do that. Anyway, let's do this.
Don't rush. Don't rush it.
I guess that's a reason why they call them rush, because it's basically just a weapon to make you go through stuff faster, even though sometimes it's required. And I don't trust this jump. I just don't.
Shake your foot.
And you just go down.
Mega Man!
Alright, going up. Alright, over here, I always get hit on purpose, otherwise I'll never be able to get in that gap. But this way I do. And besides, there's health here, so you can just get it back anyway.
And it's a chocolate wall!
Yeah, but this time no crash bombs. This time it's drill bomb.
Well, that's actually obvious, by the way.
Well, actually not. Okay. Now I got an E-Tank, now I'm maxed out on lives. I mean E-Tanks. Yeah, I'm also maxed... dude, can you cooperate? Thank you.
He doesn't know about co-op. Don't, sir!
One up that I don't need. And now we go after... Okay, this boss is probably going to make you scared for a split second. This thing is called the Square Machine.
Square... Jesus!
Behold the square!
It's a giant square! What the fuck?
Yeah, I know. Alright, so anyway, when this thing goes slow... Oops. When this thing goes slow, you can hit it. If you're really good, you can get three... If you're really good, you can get three hits in. Also, this boss is pretty easy to glitch your way through. Well, not technically to cheap your way through, but you can do this. And as you saw, I almost kind of went through it. Actually, if you do that, you will actually get hurt. So I guess the game designers knew that that could happen. Or something.
Oh my god! I just expect you to get crushed, you know?
Yeah. Well, whatever.
It's a giant box!
I was trying to do a glitch on purpose, but it didn't work.
It's a giant box of failure!
Whoa!
It's the idiot box! That's a reference to the potion there. Oh wow, does this thing go faster or what?
No, well, actually it goes fast, but when it goes fast, it doesn't look like it because of the slowdown.
Oh wow. Very good.
Well, I got three...
Ooh.
Usually the best that I can do is two charge shots and a regular shot.
Wow, that was...
Slow. Slow. Did you see that? I glitched.
Wow. Let's go slow, bro!
Slow bro hug. Kind of an inside joke, but oh well.
Yay!
And now you're going to see the first crawling stage in Mega Man history.
Really?
Yep.
They need to make a hack where it goes really fast.
And oh, speaking of scrolling, this is a good opportunity to let you show a really fun glitch.
Alright, go, go, go! Oh god, I see.
We're going to pull off a really fun glitch.
You're going to glitch yourself through the wall or something?
No, I won't do that, but it has to do with the scrollingness.
By cursing yourself or something.
I'm going to use the wire over here.
Oh god. Oh god.
And then I just let me go, and then I'll just go to outer space. Bye bye. Alright, well, I'll just hang here. Well, I can just do it, whatever.
That's a very cheap
You know, in reality, he's still going up. So, if I try to get myself down, it takes forever for him to come down.
So, go down. No, go down.
Okay,
down.
Okay, now I'm trying to mash buttons like crazy just to get myself down.
And then you die because you probably fall in that exact hole or something.
Or that exact enemy.
Or you fall upstairs. Yes, hold right. Oh.
And there we go.
So how high does this thing go up before you hit the invisible wall?
There's no invisible wall. I mean, if you mean with the wire lit.
Yeah, yes, how high can you go up?
Well, I think there's no... I don't think there's actually a limit. There might be a limit. Like, if there's a limit, it's probably like 10 screens high.
Let's do this again!
Yeah, well, if you do that, you're just getting yourself killed. Because, in this particular spot, we actually have to go inside a structure. And if you go into outer space, that's not gonna work.
Well, that was really fun to watch.
And also, this is the structure where I'm going in. That's exactly where I get killed multiple times when I try to use the balloon. Because the balloon crushed me between the balloon and the wall. I mean, the ceiling.
Oh god. Like
now, those things that look like Saturn, I don't know what they're actually called. Like
they're probably not Mr. Saturn.
People call them Saturn Seekers, but the wiki says that they're something else. So I'll just call them Saturn Seekers. And by the
because they seek for Saturn, even though they are themselves.
Okay, here you have to go fast, and I don't even know why I'm going for this E-Tank, because I'm maxed out anyway. And I can't use an E-Tank, because I'm full of health.
Go, go, go!
Yeah.
Another fun glitch that I can do by going through this door.
Oh god.
Whee! What? It didn't work! Ah! When you jump as soon as you go into that gate, you actually jump up as you stand still, which is funny. Anyway, this is the Cockroach Twins. And why are they called twins? Well, there are two phases to this fight.
Obviously.
Slow down galore.
How would you hit something? Oh.
And this one basically travels all four walls, including the death spikes.
That's very cheap! Back in the old days, enemies couldn't walk on spikes!
Back in the old days, we didn't have numbers. Back in 1927. Alright, oh well, that's the Cockroach Twins for you.
Yay, now you're at the Hey, you could go two ways. Alright,
let's do this. Dr. Cossack, I'm coming for you.
Ready? Go!
If you want to, you can just make a lot of heavy jokes because Dr. Cossack is a Russian man.
Okay, I'm going to make very many Russian jokes. Especially it's Soviet Russia jokes.
E-Tank that I don't need, again. I don't know how, but I don't.
In Soviet Russia, E-Tank needs you!
Sorry. Alright, so we have a branching path here. I'm going to take the wire road. Because the rush coil way...
In Soviet Russia, the Let's Play curse hates you!
Well, I hate you too.
Thanks, mate.
Another E-Tank I don't need. Seriously, in practice, I never had to skip...
In Soviet Russia, E-Tank doesn't need you.
Seriously, in my practice run, I never came across an E-Tank I didn't need. So I basically like skipped four E-Tanks that I didn't need because I was maxed out. Because I was getting so lucky with Eddie actually getting the E-Tanks. Anyway...
And 1-ups.
Yeah, well, 1-ups is another story.
Dr. Luna!
And now, we go after Dr. Cossack, the final battle of Mega Man 4.
Hey, comrades! What's up?
With the Cossack Catcher.
Let me kill you, comrades.
Russian. It's a giant crane.
And this thing is like extremely easy, but whatever.
It's a giant crane, like in those crane games!
The crane is late!
you just grab a doll and hopefully...
And that's it! And that's it! We beat the game! Wait, what? Proto Man? What are you doing here?
Please, Mega Man, don't! My father's not really the game off! Dr. What?
Dr. Riley!
Dr. This is a form of bomb to fight you!
Ha! Russian! look at that.
Please, Mega Man, don't hurt my father anymore!
Oh, Kalinka!
Oh, Kalinka! Father! Mega Man, forgive me!
Oh, I mean...
You betrayed me, Proto Man! I'm not the vacuum, Mega Man! Which is why can Dr. Wily teleport?
Eyebrows? Yeah, it is the annoying sound. Yeah!
Eyebrows!
Oh wait, I forgot to do the Russian voice.
Eyebrows! And off he goes.
Oh wow. 3D! One thing I don't understand. Why is he in heaven? Why would an evil guy like Wily go to heaven?
Well, I think he's just on a snowy mountain. That's all.
It looks like a cloud.
Yeah, to me it looks too, but you know, graphical limitations.
Ready? Go! What happens if you go down there? Follow the secret.
No, there's nothing hidden.
Damn it.
Another one up!
Wow,
we need a one up counter!
Easiest game in the history.
Oh yeah, by the way, Mother 3, I actually wanted to make a moron counter. Just because Wes calls Duster moron so many times. And the funny thing was, I counted it, and then at some point it actually said, you just called him moron 16 times or something like that. I mean, that was just funny.
Which is probably true or something. Yeah, Mother 3, they break the fourth wall a lot, by the way. Or
another one-up!
Or in any Mother game, they just break the fourth wall a lot. Like,
What? Press A to jump. What is this A you're speaking of?
Well, I'm gonna tell you something. Like in Earthbound, where you beat the final boss, when you go to the police officer, stay at the hotel in a certain place.
The Koopa Hotel.
And then you read the newspaper and it says, the police officer leader just finished playing Earthbound. He says, where's the sequel?
Alright, so we got magic blocks as usual, you know, every Mega Man game has to have these.
And the game definitely breaks for a while because you put in your real name, which you didn't, by the way.
Yeah, well, I didn't really care, I guess.
It's actually pretty cool how they use your name.
Okay, so all my ammo is full again.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm maxed out on lives, I have maximum E tank, I have maximum ammo, and I have full health.
You're a max!
Can I get an achievement for that? E-tank that I don't need.
Just collect it for the funds.
An E-tank that I don't need counter.
Dr. W! Dr. Wario!
Okay, so we saw meds all over the place. That probably doesn't mean that they're meds. What?
Medic!
This is Metal Daddy. This is actually a pretty tough boss.
It's a giant hard hat.
And basically his jumping attacks are actually surprisingly easy, hard to avoid. Also, when he stuns the ground, Mega Man will be stunned if you're on the ground at that point. And, well, that was just plain cheap. But, you know, like a cheap. Ow.
You're very cheap, you know?
But yeah, as you see, when he just comes out of his armor, whatever, you can hit him.
We need Dr. Russian to help.
Bam! Headshot.
Even though his whole thing is head anyway, except for his feet.
And the helmet.
Cheap headshot.
Yeah, just open up and just die.
Yeah.
Pso.
Oop. Thunder. Now we go to the next stage.
I wanted to make a funny joke, but it doesn't really work. Oh well. Alright, so over here, just take this path because all the other ones will just lead to death or dead ends. Which all have to have dead in it, or death.
Well, dead end. I see what
you're doing. Hey Luke, an E-tank I don't need. Again.
Oh, this game is funny. But I'm missing the monkeys. Speaking of monkey.
No, there are no monkeys in this game, sadly, but...
Speaking of monkey, what did Monix think of the part when the monkey got electrocuted?
You mean in Mega Man Wily Wars?
No, Mother 3.
Oh, yeah. I actually don't know, he never commented about it, and I have never asked, either.
Oh,
but
wow.
I actually did come
up. Those heads go.
But when I went on my right before I uploaded the chapter, I actually came across him while I was riding my bike to school, and well, I said to him, "You're probably gonna like the monkey chapter." Well, you won't like it until you get to the end because the end is hilarious.
Yeah.
Because Fezzet gets his ass kicked.
It's a skull. It's a skull spawner or something.
Skull dispenser.
Book dispenser here. Hey
Luke, it's a vending machine.
It's another dispenser.
It's a vending machine.
But what does it vend?
It has some sort of name, but I can't remember what it is.
It bans bullets! Dr.
Ow.
And next boss.
Dr. W versus Poison Man.
I think this thing's called the Taco Crasher. Okay, so
it will shoot tacos.
It will either shoot balls at you or breathe fire. It's all pretty easy to dodge as long as you pay attention.
Balls.
And the weak point is the green jewel on the forehead, which actually is pretty easy to miss because it has.
Because of its big hitbox.
No, it's small.
Oh, I see. Then you need to aim lower than that.
Yeah. Which isn't always the easiest thing in the world. I guess you could always just spend smaller shots, but
try to do this game without missing any shots for the Mega Buster.
I think there's actually an achievement in Mega Man 9 that has that. I know there's an achievement where you have to beat the game with the least amount of weapon energy possible. And even though I'm pretty good at preserving my
energy,
it still doesn't give me achievement.
Alright! Give me those headphones!
These are mine!
God damn it.
Hey, we're back to Skullman.
Skullman. They predicted it all! Oh my god!
Hey Luke, another E-Tank and a 1-Up I don't need. Let the counter go crazy!
Wow. They should call this 1-Up Man. Or E-Man.
In Mega Man 9, there's actually a metal that actually is disguised as a 1-Up. Which is totally evil.
Ah, you got spawncamped. Or whatever.
Well, I knew about it, but I just didn't think of it when I jumped down.
Go, go! Wow, what was that? What was the point of that?
Well, if you want weapon energy, you can go there, but I just skipped it.
Dr. W.
And onward to teleport!
Oh, this thing again.
And
right.
Onward to... Wait for it. Dr. Wily's teleport system.
Well, let's go again. What are the Robot Masters weak to?
Alright, Drill Man is weak to the dive missile.
Because drilling and diving are two different things.
Yup. Also, I like how the dive missile just goes in a recreative pattern.
It's a homing missile.
Homing missile! But overall, with his weakness, he's probably not easier than without, because, well, the homing missiles just sometimes take a long time to actually reach him, and sometimes you just can't take advantage of his invisibility frames. Anyway, next up is Bright Man!
What? Never mind. So what is he weak to?
Well, he is weak to... wait for it, because I want to get some health off of him first. He is weak to... Toad! I mean, Rain Flush! I don't know why, but I guess he can't take...
He's weak to me!
He's weak to Toad!
Yay!
Alright, next one is...
There goes the rain. Skullman!
Skullman! What are skulls weak to?
The Dust Crusher.
Of course, it crushes you to dust! And you can aim very good.
Very well, you mean.
Very well. Damn it!
Can you go away? Thank you.
Can you go away? No, you have to kill me.
No, you have to kill me!
Alright, it is...
Dive Man!
Who's weak to?
The Skull Barrier. And actually, with the Skull Barrier, he's a lot harder to kill. Because you have to get close to him.
But just do it anyway!
Yeah, because what the hell. Ow. And of course he's going to do 8 damage to me. Ow.
Oh god, you really need to heal. E-Tank that you don't use!
No. Toad Man!
He's weak to...
As if he wasn't any easier. Drill Bomb!
Drill the Toads!
Goodbye.
Wow.
Fail.
And next one it is...
Dust Man!
What is Dust weak to?
Vacuum Cleaner Man is weak to... the Ring Boomerang.
Because rings can get stuck in a vacuum cleaner.
Well, I suppose that rings don't fit in the vacuum, I guess.
Yeah, this ring is bigger than the vacuum itself.
And due to graphical limitations, it doesn't really look like a ring, but it still looks cool, nonetheless.
Oh, it returns to you, so that means you get the ammo bag! Of course not!
Not in Mega Man. In Mega Man, that doesn't make sense.
Next
onwards, part. Ring Man!
So what are rings weak to?
Weak to the Pharaoh Shot.
Rings are weak to pharaohs, because they build pyramids, not rings.
They're weak to Egyptian stuff.
What?
Yeah, I was like, screw it, let's just run into him.
Alright.
What the hell?
Well, so Pharaoh Man, because he's buried in a tomb, he never sees the light, so he's weak to bright.
Now you just sound like Gruntilda with the rhyming. Even though you're not doing...
Spam faster! Faster!
Even though you're not doing Yoda speak.
Spam faster! Faster!
Pharaoh Man dies by doing absolutely nothing.
Pharaoh Man loses by doing absolutely nothing. And you're getting hit. Really?
No. No, well,
I saw your HP drain, so whatever.
Well, maybe I had less health when I got into the battle. And now it's time for Dr. Wily!
Man.
With the Wily Machine number 4.
4?
Very slow health bar. Alright, so he's not really smart. He's not very smart here, because if you just stand over here, he can't hit you at all.
Unless you jump in front of the things, which is really dumb.
Yeah, it's really dumb.
And really stupid!
Alright, so anyway, after you shoot him enough times, he's going to get smart and his face appears.
He's going to get smart.
Okay, so in this battle, in this phase, the only way you're going to hit him with the Mega Buster is to use charged shots. And you have to be at the top of your jump if you actually want to hit him. Because you have to hit the blue crystal.
Wow. That is really hard. Or
yeah, as you see, even though it looks like I didn't do it, I actually did.
He just. What is he doing over there with his arm? Ew!
He's an ice bearer.
Is he fapping?
Oh my god!
Really, Wily?
No, he's just repeatedly pressing colorful buttons.
You mean he's repeatedly pressing the same button? Like, oh god. Guess what I'm going to say again when he's getting beat.
Oh no! He's getting away! We must kill him! No! Crap! He's getting away. Dead.
Stupid man! No, my headphones!
But there is still one more stage left.
I wonder where it goes or whatever this music is.
With more brutal Mario World music again.
What is this stage? Ready?
This stage is ready.
Go! My buddy is ready. Or something Russia. Ready is buddy.
Alright, so anyway, there are going to be some caterpillar enemies that spawn here. If any of them drop weapon energy, you need to get that to the Pharaoh Shot, because that's the Wily capsule's only weakness.
Lol.
Alright, so Pharaoh, and here we go.
Let's go! Well, where is he?
Alright, so in this battle, he is going to appear and disappear at the same time. When you see him appear, you need to quickly shoot that way, otherwise he will just get to another position. And that's pretty much the way how you beat him, there's nothing else to it.
Oh, or you just run into him.
Yeah, actually, if you do that, you actually will keep your charge shot, even though it doesn't look like it.
Oh wow, this looks
so nice. So in that way, you can actually save up more ammo that way.
Nice. Oh god, here we go again.
Ah, shoot him! Shoot him! Did I kill him?
Where is he?
Did you kill him?
No! No, not this again! I will stop with this! No! But what is left?
Eyebrows!
Goodbye! You will get me!
Danger, danger.
And... he got away again.
Hey, look! We weren't in heaven at all!
Yeah, that's what I said. We're on Snowy Mountain.
Wow, that's right.
He's smoking. No seizure.
And Mega Man is dead! Oh wait, there he goes.
No, he escapes.
What?
But wait, we can't just let him escape. No, we have to finish once and for all. Die, Wily!
Really?
Yes! He is dead! We killed him! Hooray!
Congratulations!
Yay! So,
what now?
Yeah, what now, actually? Let's go to the credits!
Alright!
And so, Mega Man killed Dr. Wily. You know, we could have just killed him with that rain earlier. I guess the rain is late!
Really?
Yep.
Bamboo!
And since we're on the train is late too! Alright, credits man, go ahead.
Escobashi and... well, that's it.
Just go.
Aw, man. Well, object designer, man.
Louder!
Train man! Toshikan Shishi! Shishi? Shishi man! Wow, this goes really slow.
Okay, Hayato man!
Ikiman! Scroll designer man!
I could just fast forward, but...
Yes, fast forward!
Blah,
blah, blah, blah. Mashoko Mamimu underscore man! Underscore...
Mamimu man!
Miss Honeymoon
Miss Dimsdale man! Teacup man!
Special... oh, whoops. Special designer man! Yasukishi NF King man!
Again.
Really? Miss Dimsdale. Because he was, man. Sound composer, man! Look at that hair. Oh, Jalen Bonbon, man?
Konnichiwa. And arigato.
Programmer, man. Hey, look. The hill is green. TK Kero-chan, man. It's...
Roll, we're home!
Woof, woof.
How long am I gonna stay in the hair like this? With this weird color background.
5 more seconds.
Dr. Wily is dead this time. Let's have a party.
Number 25, right, man. Yoshitaka Inamoto.
Man.
Oh, wow.
Asushi Amacha Otsuka Man.
I'm drilling the drill man.
Masayuki Hoshima.
Drilling.
Pharaoh man.
Finger.
Middle thing. Ring of Fire man. Hiromi Uchida man. Yes. Reference to the song The Ring of Fire.
He's not the hero.
Vacuum cleaner man.
Yusuke Murata man.
Yeah, man. How many times have I said that?
Easy man!
Dr. Wily is...
Sakura Nakayama man!
Magnet man.
Lol.
Arch! Skeleton man!
He still doesn't get it, guys. After, like, 1.5 years, he still doesn't get it. I'm sorry.
Special thanks, man!
Trust forward artifact! This is funnier when we're doing Super Mario World.
Eddie Man!
Oh, man! And that is the end of Mega Man 4 walkthrough movie.
That's it already? Wow, this one was short.
No music. So, yeah, that's it.
Really?
Next time we're going to do Mega Man 5 walkthrough movie without Tim, probably. Mega Man 6 probably too. Anything to say before you leave?
No!
Well, that's too bad, but because time's up, you're dead.
Thank you. Bye!
Thank you so much for watching my show.
Bye, Eddie.